This is a nice piece of code which is going to show you what expressions, when they are combined with logical operators and increment operators, can lead to a little bit of challenge in trying to interpret their results. So what I have done is I have declared a variable short ABC result as uninitialized short variable. So these are all integer type of variables. I have given A minus 1, B is minus 1, and C happens to be plus 1. So this program is written in a very tight space just so that we can record it properly. But please do not write code like this. This is a horrible way of writing code because it's going to be very difficult to read and understand. This is just written like this so that it's captured in a single screen. So first what I have done is I have used logical AND here. This is minus 1, this is minus 1, and this is 1. Since all of them are non-zero, result is going to be 1. So if I print result, it's going to print as 1. Alright. Now let's see what I have done here. I have done plus plus A and plus plus B and plus plus C. Now what happens is minus 1, since it's a pre-increment, when it is increased by 1, it becomes 0. 0 means false. Since this is false, it will never go to this other AND part. So only the value of A will change. A from minus 1 will become 0, and 0 will get assigned to result. So if you print result, it's going to print 0. And if you print the value of A, B and C, it's going to print 0, minus 1 and 1. It did not go to B and C because it was smart. It said AND means everything should be true. Since this is false, it refused to go into this particular part. Now let's take a look at the next expression. Here I have plus plus A or plus plus B and plus plus C. Now what has happened is A was 0, B was minus 1 and C was 1. You have to think AND has got higher precedence than OR. Alright. But this logical operators work in a unique way. What this logical AND does is, it's as good as putting this plus plus B and plus plus C in one bracket and this particular fellow in one bracket. So it tries to group them using the logical operators and then evaluates from left to right. So plus plus A, 0 becomes 1. Now since this 1 happens to be true, OR condition, it will not even go this side. So result will be 1. A will be 1, but the value of B and C will not be changed. So if you print B and C, you're going to get this result 1, minus 1 and 1. Now let's come to this part. This is AND and OR. Since AND has got higher precedence than OR, it will group plus plus A and plus plus B with AND, and this OR will remain separate. Now since this fellow is plus plus A was 1, 1 plus 1, A will become 2. B was minus 1, but B becomes 0. So this part becomes false. So it is forced to go to the C part. C is increased by 1. From 1 it becomes 2. But the result of logical operators happens to be 0 or 1. So result is going to print as 1. So when I print A, B and C, you're going to get the values 2, 0 and 2. Because only the value of A changed from plus 1 to 2. B from minus 1 it became 0. Now let's take a look at the last result. Plus plus A, A is 2, so 2 it ends up becoming 3. Now what about this? This also becomes from, it was 0. So what happened is, since it was 0, it was a post increment, so it didn't really matter. So it became false here. So it did not touch the value of B and did not touch the value of C. But since it's a post increment, the value of B is increased by 1 because it came here. So A became 3, B from 0 it became 1, and C remained as it is because it never came to this part. So when you print the value of A, B and C, you're going to print 3, 1 and 2. Just to verify, let's run it. Okay. So if you run it, you will end up seeing the output something like this. So if you see, this was 1 followed by 0, minus 1 and 1. The next one was, result was 1, then it was 1, minus 1 and 1. Then the result was 1, A was 2, B was 0 and C was 2. Finally, result was 0, A was 3, B was 1 and C was 2. So you can go ahead and try to make an effort to understand this, because this is really important that you have a combination of logical as well as increment operators. So it's going to be extensively used and going to be asked in campus placements for sure.